हेलो स्टूडेंट, वेलकम टू बायोलॉजी क्लास। माई सेल्फ ऑनिस गॉड फ्रॉम एलपीएम पब्लिक स्कूल। एंड टुडे इन दिस वीडियो लेक्चर वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द मैकेनिज्म ऑफ ब्रीदिंग। इन प्रीवियस वीडियो लेक्चर वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट ऑल द कंपोनेंट्स ऑफ द रेस्पिरेटरी सिस्टम ऑफ ह्यूमन बींग, दैट इज रेस्पिरेटरी ट्रैक एंड अबाउट द रेस्पिरेटरी ऑर्गन related to their structure. Now we will discuss about the mechanism of breathing. So first of all, let us define the process of breathing. What is the breathing? So first thing we need to know about the definition of breathing, because many times it was observed that the question arises from or starting with the definition of the breathing. So breathing is the process which involve the taking in of fresh air and giving out of foul air through our nostril. So it is called the breathing process. Now the process of breathing or the mechanism of breathing completes two stages. It means there are two stages. The one is known as inspiration and the other, second one, is known as expiration. So how inspiration differs from expiration, we will discuss here. So inspiration involves the atmospheric air is drawn in. It means when we inhale or when we drawn in the atmospheric fresh air through our nostril in our thoracic cavity, actually in our lung, it is called the process of inspiration, or it is also known as inhalation. Inspiration is also known as inhalation. And the other stage, or the second stage after inhalation, the inhalation followed by expiration or exhalation, which is this can be defined as the process in which the alveolar air is released out. It means the air that we get inhale or drawn in our thorax, in our lung, that air also must released out, and this leaking out of air take place from alveoli. So it is known as alveolar air, and the process called expiration, or it is also known as exhalation. So what are the things, or what are the structure inside our body responsible for these two stages of breathing? First of all, we need to know about them. So the factor which is responsible for these two stages of the mechanism of breathing, the first factor is the pressure gradient. So the process of, or the stage of inspiration and expiration is done by creating the pressure gradient between the lungs and the atmosphere. It means to perform the process of inspiration and exhalation, there is need of the pressure gradient between the lung and the atmosphere. So this pressure gradient is created in our body due to which structure? So the structure which are responsible for this pressure gradients are diaphragm and external and internal intercostal muscles, which are present between the ribs. Our rib cage is also responsible for the stages of breathing mechanism, that is inspiration and expiration, or to create pressure gradient. So these two muscles of our body are of our thoracic cavity. The first muscle is diaphragm, and the second, the group of external and internal intercostal muscle, which is present between the ribs. So these two muscles together play an important role to create a pressure gradient between the lungs and the atmosphere. So how they create this pressure gradient, and how this pressure gradient is responsible for the drawn, the air is drawn in and air is released out during the process of breathing. Let us discuss with the help of diagram and with the help of the information or a flow chart. So here is the flow chart of inspiration and here the flow chart of expiration. We will discuss in detail along with the diagram. So first let us understand about the inspiration, or what will happen during the inspiration to perform or to get air enter in our lung or to complete the process of inspiration. So first of all, what will happen? So to perform or to create the pressure gradient, first the process of contraction of these two muscles means the first is diaphragm and the second is intercostal muscles between the ribs and sternum. So these two muscles becomes contract, means contraction of diaphragm and contraction of intercostal muscle. So diaphragm contract, this pull the muscles, it means contraction responsible for the pulling of diaphragm towards lower side. So the thoracic cavity becomes increased towards lower side, and the contraction of intercostal muscle lift the ribs in upward direction. Lift the ribs in upward direction, or the ribs and sternum becomes raised due to intercostal muscle. So this moving towards outer side and this moving towards lower side, and these two or contraction of these two muscles responsible for the increase of volume of thoracic cavity. It means it is responsible for to increase volume of thoracic chamber, and when the thoracic cavity thoracic chamber becomes increased, then it also leads to increasing in pulmonary volume means the volume inside the lungs occupied by the alveolar sac, and that volume is especially responsible for the occupying of air that we inhale. So due to increase of pulmonary volume, the pressure inside the pulmonary sac or the alveolar sac becomes decreased. So due to decrease of pressure, the air, it resulting the air get transferred from its high pressure to low pressure. There is a common concept for all kinds, it is a natural concept that any substance transfer only in the direction from higher pressure to lower pressure. So this overall mechanism responsible to decrease the pulmonary pressure or intrapulmonary pressure, and this intrapulmonary pressure will becomes decreased in comparison to atmospheric pressure. So air get enter in our lung, and that is the process of inspiration or inhalation. Now on other hand, what will happen when these muscles becomes relaxed, or they get transferred to its original position? So when these muscles becomes relaxed after contraction, all the muscles need to be relaxed. So during relaxation of diaphragm and intercostal muscle, the thoracic volume becomes decreased due to the diaphragm become relaxed, and the intercostal muscle the intercostal muscle of the lip also becomes relaxed. So this represents the ribs and sternum come to relax mode. So due to coming of these two structures in the relaxed mode, the air inside the or the volume of thoracic chamber or thorax becomes decrease or reduce. So due to reduce of volume of thorax, the it also leads to the decrease of pulmonary volume. It means when the volume of thorax becomes reduced, then it leads to the decrease of pulmonary volume. And due to decrease of pulmonary volume, the pressure, which pressure? The intrapulmonary pressure becomes increased. Due to increase of intrapulmonary pressure, the air inside the pulmonary sac or the alveolar sac get out of the or released out of the lung. It means this air released out in atmosphere. So in this condition, the due to decrease of pulmonary volume, the increase, it leads to increase in intrapulmonary pressure, and due to increase in intrapulmonary pressure, the air transferred towards the lower pressure. It means it is the nature of air that it always transfer from high pressure to low pressure. So in the process of exhalation, the air gets released out into the atmosphere from the atmosphere, and that is the process of expiration. So this is our overall mechanism of breathing, through which air is drawn in and air is released out. And an average breathing rate of a healthy human body is about 12 to 16 times per minute. It means a healthy body in normal condition breathe about 12 to 16 times per minute. In 1 minute they breathe 12 to 16 times. Now this rate of breathing can be increased also, or can be raised also, with the help of our abdominal muscle. So here it is also need to be known, the abdominal muscle also help to raise our rate of breathing. So during the vigorous condition, we can also increase our rate of breathing to get maximum amount of oxygen to generate efficient energy to do the efficient work of our body, and that is done with the help of some extra abdominal muscles. And an instrument which is known as spirometer, we will also take this topic, the spirometer. So spirometer is an instrument that is responsible, or that it is helpful to measure the volume of our thorax, or that is responsible to measure pulmonary volume, and that volume of lung, after measuring, it is helpful in clinical diagnosis of a particular disease. It means to diagnose a number of diseases related to our breathing problem or related to our respiratory system can be also diagnosed and with the help of spirometer. And spirometer is an instrument that responsible to measure pulmonary volume. So after measuring with the spirometer, we can also enhance our pulmonary volume with the help of the abdominal muscle or effort of abdominal muscle. So we can increase our capacity to acquire a high amount of air inside our lung to maximize the chances of absorption of oxygen in more quantity. And when the absorption of oxygen will be taken by our body in more amount, so it leads to fulfill the requirement of energy of our body, because we are the organism that only depend on aerobic respiration. Sometimes anaerobic respiration also taking place in our body during vigorous condition, but in anaerobic condition we do not acquire that amount of energy which is acquired by aerobic respiration. So to perform efficient amount of aerobic respiration, we need to raise our pulmonary volume, and that is responsible for a good health of our body. Actually, if all the nutrients are get in our body but there is no sufficient oxygen taken by our lung or our respiratory system, so that sufficient amount of nutrient will be not favorable for our body or not beneficial for the health of our body. So overall, from this video lecture, I try to understand the concept of breathing and how breathing is responsible for a good health, and or how we can increase the breathing efficiency or increase pulmonary volume, and how this increasing of pulmonary volume responsible for our good health. So this is an overall video lecture for the mechanism of breathing or related to breathing. I hope you will understand clearly from this video lecture.